morning. My name is Jillian Giesbrecht and I am 20 years old. I grew up in a loving Christian home. We attended church regularly and my parents prayed with and for me daily and encouraged me to read my Bible. I accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior at an early age here at Bethany back when we had Rainbow Connection. I am truly thankful for the strong foundation of faith my parents and my Sunday school teachers fostered in me as a child. It wasn't until around grade 4 that I really started to struggle. I had low self-esteem, anxiety, and very few friends. I was bullied. I tried to act like the good Christian girl I knew I should be, but I deeply desired to be liked and accepted. As I got older, the pressure grew. If I did what the popular kids were doing, would I have more friends? Well, the kids at school were telling me to wear shorter skirts and wear more makeup, my parents told me to live differently. I began to build resentment for my Christian ways. I went to a Christian high school where I built new and better friendships with a great group of Christian girls. I no longer felt the pressure to conform in order to fit in. But my anxiety and low self-esteem got worse. I avoided most social situations and I lost quite a few friends. I found it difficult to leave the house. I had a stress list the length of a book. I was an emotional wreck. My life was centered on worry and stress. Jesus took a back burner position in my life. I still prayed and read my Bible occasionally, but it was mostly an afterthought and it felt like a chore. During my last year of high school, in my desperation to be accepted and loved, I quickly clung to the first person to show an interest in me. I dove headfirst into this relationship, but it quickly became unhealthy. I ignored the red flags and God's voice yelling, "No, turn back, this is not my best for you." My friends and family echoed this, and I pushed them all away. I pushed God away. "No, God, you don't know what's best for me." My relationship put me through a lot, but I continued to suffer through it because that's what Christians do, right? We forgive time and time again. But as we learned a few weeks back, loving others does not mean you need to continue trusting people who hurt you, manipulate you, or let you down. Eventually, I realized this, yet I wasn't strong enough to end the relationship. I felt like I had lost everybody in my life, even God. I felt completely alone. But God hadn't abandoned me. After a year and a half of abuse, God finally got through to me. He told me he had better things in store for me. He told me to trust him. He waited with his hand outstretched towards me. I took a leap of faith and took his hand. It was the best decision I've ever made in my life. After ending my relationship, I worked on rebuilding the other friendships and relationships I had abandoned. My true friends revealed themselves, and I quickly built up deeper, stronger relationships with them. My family and I are closer than we've ever been. And most importantly, my relationship with God has flourished. I seek his guidance every day. Jesus is the rock my life is built on. I desire to please him, not the world. Romans 12:2 says, "Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." The last year has been the best year of my life. I live to glorify God in everything I do. I strive to live intentionally and to embrace God's vision for my life. One of my favorite verses is Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." In times of doubt and in times of fear, I know that God has a plan for my life better than I could ever build for myself. Romans 8:28 says, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." I try my best to listen to God's calling and not run from it, even though it scares me sometimes. God has never let me down, and I seriously doubt he would start now. My mom and my sister have had a huge part in my faith journey. They encourage me and they model what it means to live for Christ in a God-honoring way. I serve in Kids Zone here at Bethany to an amazing group of kids, and to be honest, sometimes I think they teach me more than I teach them. They've revealed to me God's heart and his amazing love. I am no longer ruled by fear. I let God have control. I've always been too scared to get baptized because of the public speaking aspect, but I'm not going to let fear stop me. I'm going to be baptized today to declare that Jesus is the Lord and Savior of my life. He's forgiven me and healed my heart. He's loved me unconditionally even when I turn my back on him. Today I take his outstretched hand once again and follow him as he leads me through this crazy journey that is life. I am not afraid. I am excited to see where he'll take me. Thank you.
Jillian, you were afraid because of public speaking. Man, you did well. You knocked it out of the park. What a story. Thank you for sharing it, because I'm sure it's a story that so many people can relate to as they try to figure out who they are and who God is in life. The book of Isaiah, it says, "Those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will mount up on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and they will not faint." Lord, to thank you for Jillian's life, her testimony, for the powerful impact her sister and her mom have had in other people. And now she is using her gifts to your glory in our kids' ministry and impacting lives. And it's all for your glory and for your purpose. We're so grateful. May Jillian never forget this day when she made public her commitment to follow Jesus. In your name I pray. Amen.
Jillian Giesbrecht, on confession of your faith in Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.